Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today we'll be installing Elrond Node. We'll be using an awesome tutorial by Sever Moldovan. We're gonna just be following all the steps down all the way. I, of course, will not be showing you the guide itself, just gonna copy these commands off screen. So, we'll be using Google Cloud for this. So you can set up a free account. Just go to Google Cloud. Let's go back home. Okay, go to the Compute Engine and then VM Instances. I'll have one instance already running. Then you'll all have to go to Create Instance. Let's name it Elrond 2. Must be all lowercase and must include a number. Let's say we want this, let's do custom, 6 CPUs, 12 gigs of RAM, let's change the disk image to Ubuntu, let's say 300 gigs. You could do more, it depends on how many nodes you want to run. It's recommended 200 gigs for each node, so you could do that. Okay, everything is set up. Let's click create. You could also choose an SSD, but currently Google Cloud is not allowing to use SSD space. So this might take a while. If you get red instead of green, go and check here. Sometimes it gives you some kind of limitations like CPU limit, or you can't use faster N2 CPUs. Oh, here we go. We have an error. It only allows 8 CPU limit in the region. Okay, so let's delete this. And let's create it in another region. Just let's change the region to the Netherlands. Elrond 2. Okay, let's change it to 6 CPUs, 12 gigs. Again, Ubuntu 300, select. Great. It might take a few minutes. Okay, we have it on green, it's running. Now click on the SSH and new window will open. And we are connecting to our virtual machine. So let's assume we are installing Elrond nodes for the first time and we don't have any keys. A great idea is always to upgrade your, first update your machine. It will get all the latest stuff and then upgrade. Sudo apt-get. Upgrade. Yes, I'll include the several commands in the description. We want yes. Okay, we start from the fourth step. You can usually just paste the commands here, so it's pretty quick. Git clone and the URL to the scripts. Now we go to the scripts. You can check what's in your current directory by typing ls. So currently we downloaded the scripts. On the fifth step, we have to edit variables.cfg file with our username. So let's find out our username. You just type who am I. Okay, so we copy our username. And before we want to edit, we can install a very useful thing. It's called Midnight Commander. So you type sudo apt-get install mc, then you click yes, just type mc and you get a window like this. You can actually browse where you want and just use arrow keys and enter to go in and out into the folder. So we now have to go to Elrond Go scripts v2, click enter, then go to config, enter, go to variables, And now here at the bottom, you can see there's edit, delete, all the stuff, quit. So we want to edit this file. We click F4 on the top of the keyboard. Type in 3 and press enter. Now we have to modify these two lines here. Delete this and paste our username, or just you can type it if you didn't copy previously. Now we have these two lines modified. You click F2 for saving. You get this window, you click enter and save, and then F10 to close that, and F10 key to close this again. Okay, so we now have modified our configuration variables file. Next, step 6, to make sure everything works, it's mainly for the auto updater. And now you must type the username here. We had Dragomiras. Okay, with this one, you will want to hit Control X to exit. So just do that. It's here at the bottom. It says Control Exit. And it'll ask you if you want to save. Yes, press yes, of course. Okay, moving on to the next step. Now we're gonna create our folder for validator keys. Okay, now we're gonna install nodes as the service. Change the directory to the Erlang Go scripts v2.slash script.sh install. As harsh install. It asks how many nodes do you want to run. For this configuration, let's do 3. This will just go and install all the necessary dependencies. We'll install Go, so give it some time. When it will stop, it'll ask you to choose a name for your node. We must now choose a name, so you can do something like this, like my awesome node node dash underscore. Okay, we now copy this. Okay, let's delete that. Underscore 1. And then just paste it. 2. And then 3. This is an important step. You should type yes. Okay, nodes are installed. Next, we just have to start them. Just script.sh start. Okay, starting the nodes. Just wait a few seconds for them to start up. In the meantime, you can check if you have everything working with the auto updater. So type in cron tab dash l from the 12th step. Okay, you should have two lines like this. We want to check if the node is actually running. So for this, you'll need this command. And first, we must go back, or you have to go to this directory. You must have Erlang utils. And again, we paste this. This means we're gonna start the node 0, the first node we have installed. And here we have the node is running as observer. Here we have the latest version, our public key transaction signature. We can see it's syncing at 9 minutes until it'll fully sync up. Nonce, current round, usage, this is the log. To close this, let's just hit Control C. For the other nodes, you have to change the port, actually, not this. Okay, so it should be like this. Now we are on the second node. Control C to close. So you need this. It all depends on the port. My awesome node 3. Okay, we have three nodes running. Another interesting thing, you can check your auto update status. So we can just paste it cat auto update dot status. We don't have such a file or directory. We can check if it runs by pasting the command from the 12th step. We just need to change this user to Dragomeras. The auto updater will run each 10 minutes. To run the previous command, just use the arrow keys to go up and down. So let's. Okay, it says we are on the latest version of GitHub. So you can check this file, let's say after 10 minutes, and you should get another entry like this with the date and everything. One more important thing to know is the command htop. Just type it. You will get a lot of information here. You can hit shift H to type the H capital, and it will all clear up, and you'll have your three nodes on top running. Here you'll have your CPU usage. Current is quite high. The file, here you can see the memory usage, the node, your instance uptime. Here you can see the node uptime. Okay, to close this, just go to F10 and it'll close. Another interesting thing you can do is check how much nodes are taking up of the space. So for this, you'll need do dash hs and then the folder you want for it. So you don't have to type full commands, just type, let's say, lrn and type and click tab, and then tab, and it's all the folder. So currently three of our nodes are using 2.7 gigabytes. Let's say, just for demonstration purposes, we want to check how much scripts are taking up space. So you get 352 kilobytes. So, and then again, to go back the run the previous command, you can use cat auto update dot status. Okay, actually the auto updater just checked, and we have two entries. So let's say we want to look at our node. We go back, and the first node, 8080 port, hit enter, and here we have our node running. Okay, another important thing, we should backup our keys. For this, we must go to our nodes. Okay, let's change directory, Elrond nodes, and let's go to node zero. Let's go to config less, and here we have our keys. And let's use the tutorial step 8. Just go node zip node 0.pem. Okay, we have a zip file. Now we can move this to our validator keys directory. Okay, now it's moved. Okay, let's go back, let's change node 1, change directory node 1, ls, change config, and let's repeat, and you have to repeat this process for as many nodes as you have. This is gonna be, since the second node, it will do node-1zip. Okay. Now we need this command again. It simply says move node 1 to the specific directory. Okay, let's check it's moved. Let's repeat this one more time. 2 ls. Okay, change to contact ls. And one more time, zip node 2. If you forget which number you were, you just check above, you'll see it's node 1. Okay. And again, let's move it to validator keys. Oh, mistakes were made. 2. Okay, it's got moved. So let's go back. We could just simply go cd. I don't know what this thing called. Okay. And all our keys now are in validator folder. So let's go here, ls. Let's say you want to using Google Cloud to download all of it, so you could download all these separately, or you could zip them up. Yeah, it's your choice. So just go zip node something like all dot zip, and then go asterisk dot zip. And now we have node all zip. Let's just check what's inside. Just open MC and you can check the what's inside. That's an easier. Okay, let's close the MC. F10. Okay, since it's Google Cloud, you can go here and download file. And for this, you'll need your full directory. So you need to type. You need to type pwd and you'll get all the directory you need. And you can just copy it. And now you'll have to remember name node underscore all dot zip. Go here, download the file. This is just to move your keys out of the cloud to all to your system. And type all the directory and the file name itself and click download. It'll tell us now all zip finished. So now you can open your keys you just downloaded. Okay, so probably that's all the wisdom I can offer you here. If you need any more help, just go to validator's chat in Telegram. I'll leave a link to the description, and someone will sure you help you out. So thanks you for watching, and hit that like button.